week's movie is Ocean's 8. Yes, it comes after Ocean's 11, 12, and 13 from about a decade ago. Why? Well, first off, I think we need to establish that George Clooney and Brad Pitt decided to revive the Rat Pack version of Ocean's 11 along with Steven Soderbergh in 2001. Basically, the movie to me was just a bunch of good-looking guys walking around in good-looking suits just hanging out together, and that was the fun of the movie. Yeah, there was a heist, but that seems sort of secondary to why you really wanted to see this movie. It was kind of a gossipy kind of a thrill ride for celebrity fans of celebrity actors. Along comes 2018 and Ocean's 8, and we have a female-centric cast. In fact, it's almost entirely made up of women. And what's different about it? Well, it's different in that it's good-looking women instead of good-looking men walking around in good-looking outfits and just sort of hanging out together, and that's kind of the fun of it. The heist, the plot line, if it was a throwaway in the originals, it's even more of an afterthought in this particular version. There are so many holes in the heist, it's ridiculous, but nobody really goes to these kinds of movies because they want to make sure they've got this incredible heist movie. They want to see glamour, and glamour is what's on display here. Who's in it? You've got Sandra Bullock. How they tie this in with the other Ocean's movies, Sandra Bullock plays Debbie Ocean, who is the sister of Danny Ocean, who is played by George Clooney in the original three movies. She decides that she, once she gets out of prison, she served a sentence for 5.5 years, she wants to come up with the biggest heist in the history of heists, and she gets a lot of her women friends or con artists to work together, and so you have this really high profile A-list cast. Got in addition to Sandra Bullock, you've got as the victim Anne Hathaway, you have Kate Blanchett, you got Helena Bonham Carter, you got Rihanna, you got Mindy Kaling and other people. They all get together to work on what? They decide they're going to steal a $150 million necklace from around the neck of this big shot actress played by Anne Hathaway. It's not really Anne Hathaway, it's just played by Anne Hathaway. It really is not much of a storyline, but it is kind of fun to see them all, you know, getting to dress up and hang out. One of the surprising things about it, oh, by the way, in terms of the heist, it's pretty good. For about 20 minutes, it's pretty tense when they actually try to pull off the theft. But except for that, there's really, it's just not a very believable plot. Very, a lot of holes in it and all that. So if you're going to see it for the heist component, you're going to be sorely disappointed. The one thing I was kind of surprised at and somewhat disappointed in is that they don't take advantage of the fact that it's all women. That there's nothing particular about the heist that requires women. There's nothing, it's also gender neutral, that you could have easily done Ocean's 8 with an all-male cast and it would have been the same. There's no kind of female solidarity. I think there's one line Sandra Bullock says, oh, women are always ignored, and so this is one time we're going to take advantage of that. We're going to pull off this big theft and we're going to be ignored, and that's good because we want to be ignored in this case so we can rip off this big diamond. I guess the idea here is that it's really about just watching celebrity actresses prance around acting like celebrities, and the movie does deliver on that. It's not a great justification for a movie, but it's something. I think it's not something so interesting that we'll have an Ocean's 9 and an Ocean's 10 like we did with the men's version, but you know, we'll see what the box office does. It's a ho-hum movie. Could have been a lot better, but at least you do get to see glamorous women dressing up and looking glamorous.
All of my movie reviews are brought to you by Red Wind Casino. See them here first on the KIRO Radio Facebook page and find all of them at MyNorthwest.com.